Hey, what's going on, guys? I want to talk about these Maxpedition cooler bags. It's finally time for review. I've been using these since these first hit the market. I was extremely excited to see them. Coincidentally, I was looking for a cooler of some kind at the time when they came out, so it obviously made sense to get these. But I got these because I wanted my gear to match, and I wanted to get a high-quality bag, and I was not let down by that. I will say that they're expensive. Some people would say they're overpriced, but it's really a matter of opinion. If you want a bag like this, this is the price you have to pay. The small one here is called the Fillup, and they sell for about $70 to $75. And the bigger one sells for about $80. That's called the Chow Down. All right. Now, right off the bat, I would suggest if you're going to get one of these things to get the bigger one because of the price difference. If this was like $40 and this was $80, I would say, all right, well then, you know, get whatever is going to fit your needs better. But because they're so similar in price, why not go with the extra capacity? The only reason I would see anyone getting the smaller one is if this is going to be a dedicated lunch bag for work. All right, if you're one of those people that brings your lunch or whatever food to work daily, on a daily basis, you know, what are your options? You got paper bags. That's okay. It's cheap. It's a little wasteful, but whatever. You got the 70s and 80s movie style lunch boxes with matching thermoses. Super cool. Or nostalgic. Or stupid, depending on who you are. And then you have cooler bags like this. These are soft shell cooler bags. There's no hard internal frame, but they do hold their shape because of the thick padding that they have in there. All the walls are padded on the inside. They do keep everything nice and cool. Their basic functions are perfect. Or in the other case, if you want to put something hot in there, it'll retain that heat for a long period of time. So, why would you get these? Why would you pay four or five times as much money for something like this as opposed to, you know, Kmart or Walmart lunch bag or something you find online? It's the quality of the bag. And it's like anything else. You buy quality, you're going to spend more money once, and you'll have it for many years to come. I don't baby these things just like any of my gear. I'm a huge fan of Maxpedition to begin with, and so I wanted it to match the stuff I already have. But I knew the quality. I knew what to expect. I can get a $20 bag. I'm sure it'll keep my stuff just as cold for just as long of a period of time. But I know eventually it's going to have problems. You know, on these, it's the same quality you're going to get in any of the gear you get from Maxpedition. The same 1,000 denier nylon, the same good stitching. Everything is nice and secure on here. YKK brand zippers, that makes a difference. I've never had a YKK brand zipper ever have a problem, ever. I've had coats and jackets and stuff and different bags before that zippers broke. I always looked at them. They were never, ever a name brand zipper. YKK is the top. Just like every other piece of material that goes into this, all right? These happen to both have webbing all over them, all right? So you can build off of them if you want to make them bigger, if you have something else to use all the time, if you have a cell phone case or something. I mean, you can attach anything to this bag to build off of it if you wanted to. Or, especially if you're using this for like a daily lunch bag or something, you could stick a flashlight in here, a spare knife, you can clip whatever you want to it. So you have that option, whereas any store brand one's not gonna have that. They might have a pocket here or there, but they're certainly not gonna have webbing like that. I'm going to go over these one at a time, all right, and then I'm going to give like an overall opinion on them at the end. I can tell you this one gets used. Christina uses this a lot more than I do, but that's the bag right there that I use, and I use that four or five times a month, every single month, sometimes more. Whenever I'm doing my traveling, I use that. I go to my parents' house a lot. They live in Pennsylvania like I do, but they're nowhere near me. It's a very far trip, so if I'm bringing drinks, I want to stay cold, or if I'm bringing bags of frozen vegetables or meat or whatever. All kinds of stuff. I'll put it in there, and I use it pretty much every single time I go to see them. All right, so I want to review these individually. So the first one we're looking at here is the small one. Again, this one's called the Fillup. All right, for search purposes, if you want to look this up, it's called the Fillup cooler bag from Maxpedition. The size on this one is 10.75 inches by 6 inches by 7 inches. All right, as mentioned, there's webbing all over it. All right, both sides and the back. All right, the top has a very, very secure handle. It does come with a shoulder strap, which I do not use. All right, but if you were to use this or just clip onto these D-rings here, all right, very stiff clips. All right, very secure. The clips are plastic and so are the D-rings, just as a note there. But I don't use these shoulder straps at all. All right, I just don't have a use for them. If you were, you know, carrying a bunch of things at once, it would make sense to throw this over the shoulder, but I just don't use them. To me, it's just extra material, a waste of space. There is a pocket in the front here, all right? Because this is a smaller one and because I think the main purpose for this would be a daily lunch bag. The pocket on the front, I think, is essential. This is where you're gonna put your utensils, spoons, forks, butter knives, maybe salt packets, little things of butter. Who knows? It depends on whatever you're eating. All your accessories and stuff would go in there, napkins, stuff like that. All right, so pretty essential to have a pocket on the front. Now, they put a strip of Velcro on here, which is pretty cool. Now, originally I thought like, oh yeah, you could throw some patches on there, whatever. But it kind of dawned on me, it's in the shape of a name badge, all right? So if you have a custom name badge you can have for this, especially again, with the idea of using this for a lunch bag every day, you can put your last name on a name plate or name tape and stick that on the front. So that's a good, cool little addition to that. Or again, you could throw on your patches if you want, but it is a single like 1-inch strip, all right? So it's not gonna hold the big fat patches, at least not super securely. As far as the inside goes, top zippers, there's two zippers on here. All right, they have paracord pulls on them. You open up, you see there's padding on all the walls, very thick padding. So again, this is a soft, you know, bag. It doesn't have a stiff like plastic or metal frame in it, but it is very rigid. All right, it holds its shape very easily because of all this thick foam in here. What the foam's gonna do is it's gonna allow this to be a little safer and more cushioned, especially if you're putting glass in here. If you have, you could stack beer bottles in here. I've done that before. The glass stays very secure in here. If your, I don't know, glasses of maybe bottles of Snapple, you know, stuff like that. So you don't have to worry about putting more fragile items in here. Never had anything break on numerous occasions, carried glass back and forth and never dropped it, you know, because I'm careful. But I would imagine it would definitely keep the glass more secure in stickier situations than some other bags. I do like the fact that it's really thick. All right, it's got to be at least, you know, 3/4 inch thick foam on all the walls here. So very cool. Did keep everything super cold. There was only one occasion where I put something hot in here and it did retain its heat. So it works both ways. But I do use them as a cooler way more than I use it as like a hot bag. All right, as far as the size or capacity on these, the small one, again, the Fillup is what this is called. It's 249 cubic inches or 4.1 liters. All right, to give you a reference, you could put a 6-pack of soda cans in here or beer, whatever you want. Fits with room on all sides and the top. Okay, so just as a reference. So that is the small one. Again, these are $72, pretty much everywhere, anywhere from like, I don't think I've seen it less than 70, but I've seen it as high as 80. So let's say between $70 and $80 for the small ones, but if you shop around, it'd be about $70. All right, on to the bigger bag. This bigger bag is called the Chow Down. Okay, it's 12 inches by 7 inches by 10 inches. I think it is significantly bigger than the other one. The capacity on the inside, it's a lot deeper, holds 440 cubic inches of space or 7.2 liters. You could put full-size beer bottles in here, holds a 12-pack of bottles, okay? And speaking of bottles, what I liked about this one, which is a nice little surprise, is it comes with this strap. If you didn't like this, you could cut this off below the stitching, all right, so you know, as to not ruin the bag. But I thought it was pretty cool. And it comes with this black bottle opener, all right, so it's always with the bag. So if you happen to be filling this with beer, or bottles of soda that you know need a you know, cap lifter or bottle opener, it has one with it, which is pretty neat. This tucks away in a side pocket. As you saw on the other bag, there's the straps all the way around it. This only has it on one side. The other side has a bottle opener. This holds a canteen, you know, a big water bottle. You can put full-size wine bottles or liquor bottles in here. Holds pretty steady. There's elastic across the top strap. All right, so it stays tight in there. The D-rings are on the sides. Also plastic. This also does come with a shoulder strap, just like the other one. The only difference is this shoulder strap came with a pad as opposed to the other one. But they're on the sides for better weight distribution as opposed to the top because it's a bigger bag. On the back, there's a Velcro strap, okay, as well as a handle, okay, a padded handle, which is very nice. You can use this to either add to other bags by, you know, attaching it through this strap, whatever you want to do. If you had a big backpack and want to attach this to the backpack, you can do so. Or it just gives you more leverage for holding it, okay, especially if it's heavier. Because it's bigger, and if you're going to fill this with, you know, cans of soda or beer or whatever, all that liquid, it's going to create a lot of weight. It does have a bigger patch holder in the front. Velcro goes all the way across, holds the bigger patches, which I really like. Just threw these on here. There's also Maxpedition patches. Same handle on the top, very much reinforced. You can really pull and tug on this. It's not going anywhere. That's pretty much it for these. They work great. They keep everything nice and cold. The small one, definitely better for a dedicated lunch bag every day, you know, for work. The bigger one here, better for camping situations or traveling. especially if you have a big family with kids. You throw in some Gatorade in there, soda, water, whatever you want, some snacks and stuff like that. You know, if you're on the road with kids, I don't have kids of my own yet. I hope to one day, but I know they can get annoying. And most people love them. I love kids too. They're great and everything, but they can certainly get noisy and annoying. So that's when you could throw a snack bar at them and a bottle of water or something to keep them quiet for a while. I don't know if that was a really nice thing to say or a horrible thing to say. But anyway, I like these bags a lot. And like I said, I'm going to have these for many years to come. The quality is top notch. They are expensive. They're pricey bags, but you're getting, you know, what you're paying for. I don't think it's overpriced. It's easy for someone to say that because they don't have a personal use or need for them. If you're in the market for a cooler bag and you want something that's going to last and not break on you, and if it does break, it's going to be replaced with no questions, these are the bags to get. If you want to save some money, get a cheap bag, but you'll probably end up having problems with it down the road and have to buy it again and again and again. There's a difference between buying something cheap and saving up and buying something of quality. You know, that could be a whole video on itself. But anyway, I just want to do a review on these after lots and lots of use on these. I still love them. They do offer a bunch of different colors, as most of their gear. I got the blacks just because it's simple and I like it. So anyway, that's all. That is my review of the small Maxpedition cooler bag called the Fillup and the large one called the Chow Down. Very cool bags. So thanks for watching. Hope you guys enjoy the rest of your day and I will see you soon. Take care.